what Jesus has brought to us is the opportunity to see all of that redeemed. But if we don't know, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So if we don't know that our spirit can be wounded, then we're not even looking for our spirit to be healed. So Caleb had a different spirit in him. And I just wanted to bring that out just to share with you that it is important to understand the difference between the three. That my soul, my emotions may need healing, my body may need healing, and my spirit may also need healing. Thank you, Jesus. Denise, do you have anything you want to share on that at this moment? Because I think what we're going to do is we're going to pray for some folks' healing in their spirit.
The one thing that keeps coming back to me is that when you allow your spirit to be healed, it will heal your body and it will heal your emotions. Your body doesn't have to be healed first, or your emotions don't have to be healed. It's your spirit. And that spirit is what he was talking about. It's what you're sensing when you're in the womb. It's what you're sensing from trauma. The whole time he's up here talking, this picture is being painted in my head of women who go through abuse, how their spirits are broken, and they'll stay in those abusive relationships because of what they know, but won't leave because of what they fear. And it's not where they want to stay, but it's become comfortable. It's become familiar. And we can't stay where we're comfortable. We can't stay where we're familiar, because God's calling us to advance. And if we're going to advance, it's likely going to be where we've not been before. So we may not know what that's going to look like. We may not know what that's going to feel like. We may not know what that's going to cost us. But we do know the Christ that leads our steps. And so allow your spirit to be healed. And as your spirit is healed and renewed and revived, everything else comes into alignment.
Amen, amen, amen. So we'll bring us back to the elephant. And this is just, if you feel in some place in your spirit, in your heart, Holy Spirit is helping you to witness and discern in this moment, that maybe you're a little bit like that elephant. And as Denise said, it's they fear the unknown. They fear going into the new thing. And maybe you're like that elephant. And that elephant, if you can see how humongous that elephant is, so the strength of that elephant is obviously greater than that little old rope that's binding it. But the elephant doesn't have it in itself to just go ahead and break free. That if you find that in yourself this morning, we're going to pray for your spirit and for your healing. Not just that Jesus heals you, but that you need to take that step. You need to break that cord by taking the step and believing your freedom. Believing in the strength that God has placed in you. Believing in the anointing. Believing in the Holy Spirit that's in you. The power that's in you. Before I take that last step into that, Kai, is there anything on your heart that you want to? All right. So, Lord Jesus, I thank you that you are a deliverer. And I understand, Lord, that there are some people in here, and there's some people that may be listening, that they don't understand what it means that they're a spirit being. And they don't understand that their spirit needs healed. But you're still a healer and a deliverer. So I'm asking you, even as I prayed in the beginning about the new wine, though this may be a new wine, woo, that it begins to flow right now. Bring healing right now to the spirit of every individual that hears this that needs healing in their spirit. God, allow them to clearly see what it is that they need healing from. And your power, your anointing, rest in this place, pour through this place, come out in this place, God. Even in the airwaves, even online, wherever they may be hearing this, God, that your presence and your power release every single person from any bondage that they may be in, that there's from the hurt, from the wound, from the trauma that their spirit is experiencing. And Lord, we command trauma to go in the name of Jesus. Lord, every bit of trauma, we say the blood of Jesus covers all trauma in every spirit, every person that's hearing this message. The blood of Jesus has been poured out for your healing and deliverance. Your God is your deliverer. Your God is mighty, and that you will come forth from this day in the power and in the might and in the Spirit of God. That you are coming forth right now in power, in the Spirit, and in might, in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Now, the Bible says that we need to let go of, and we need to get free from any superfluity, a naughtiness of spirit. So what it's saying is that there can be some filth in our spirit that we did not recognize. Woo! Woo! And there's some things that some people have been entrapped by. You've had a snare in your life that you haven't been able to get by some of the things in your life that keep drawing you. And I'm telling you, there's been some filth in your spirit that the Spirit of God and the blood of Jesus is cleansing right now. That your spirit is going to begin, has turned and is turning towards what is right and what is righteousness. That you're no longer going to be bound, and you're no longer going to be deterred by the iniquity that has been laying in your spirit, but the blood of Jesus is cleansing you and healing you, and he has been broken so that you can be free. Woo! And he is renewing within you a right spirit. Woo! A right spirit within you. And for those places that you did not know, that you were just unaware, there's grace and mercy. And as God is showing you about your spirit and what you need to be renewed, revitalized in your spirit, that you can come forth in the mighty hand of God, that you can come forth in a breakthrough spirit. Some of you are carrying a breakthrough anointing. Some of you are going to go lay your hands on the sick that they be healed and delivered. Some of you are going to be out in the streets ministering the gospel. Some of you are going to be able to be raising the dead. Some of you are going to be so on fire and so inspired that you can't go places without laying hands on the sick that they be healed. Some of you didn't recognize that there was something going on in your spirit, but the Spirit of God today has healed you from that in the depths of your being, and you're going to go out in fire and on fire, and you're going to minister as God has given you to minister, and you're going to speak the word of the Lord. And as the word of the Lord comes forth, there's going to be signs and wonders and miracles. And in the place where there's been delay, there will no longer be delay, but you will see action come forth in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you for the restoration of your people, that this is a day and this is an hour of restoration, that redemption